Now we will study what are the methods of improving commutation. So two types of methods are there. First type we will study in part 1 and second type we will study in part 2. In our previous videos we have studied what are the effects of armature reaction. So because of armature reaction, there is demagnetization or weakening of the main flux, and due to armature reaction, there is cross magnetization or distortion of the main flux. Now because of the first effect, the generated voltage is get reduced, and because of the second effect, the commutation will not be proper, means there will be sparking at brushes, and this is mainly because of shifting of magnetic neutral axis. And here we should note that both these effects will increase with increase in armature current, that is with increase in load, and therefore some corrective action must be taken to neutralize the effect of demagnetization and effect of cross magnetization of the main flux. Now let us see first of all compensating winding. Now we have seen because of armature reaction there is demagnetization and cross magnetization. This compensating winding is useful to neutralize the effect of demagnetization. Now this demagnetization effect is a serious problem, particularly if the machine size is large. Now if the load is fluctuating, then large armature current will suddenly increase or decrease, and therefore this demagnetization will be a serious problem. And we have to provide a compensating winding. So compensating winding is mainly used to solve the problem of demagnetization, and it is mainly used in case of large DC machines which are subjected to large fluctuations in load. Now this compensating winding, it is placed in the pole shoes of the main poles. So in the pole shoes of the main poles, the slots are provided, and in these slots the compensating winding is placed, and this compensating winding is connected in series with armature. So you can see here this compensating winding, it is connected in series with armature. Now the current in the compensating winding is such that it is opposite to the current flowing in the armature conductors. So here these are the armature conductors under north pole, and the conductors under north pole, they are carrying a current which is inward, and therefore the current in the compensating winding which is placed in north pole, the direction of current, it must be outward. Similarly, the conductors under south pole, these armature conductors, they carry a current which is outward, and therefore the compensating winding which is placed in south pole, this winding will carry a current which is inward. So the direction of current in the compensating winding is opposite to the direction of current in armature conductors which are directly below the pole shoes. Now because of this arrangement, the magnetomotive force produced by compensating winding is opposite to the magnetomotive force produced by armature conductor under the pole faces. Now, as the flux produced by compensating winding and flux produced by these armature conductors is opposite to each other, then it can neutralize the effect, demagnetizing effect of armature reaction. And if we can adjust the ampere turns produced by compensating winding equal and opposite to the ampere turns produced by armature current, then we can neutralize the demagnetizing effect completely and the flux will remain unchanged for all magnitudes of load on the machine. Means even if the load is changed, the main flux will remain unchanged because of this compensating winding. But the main disadvantage of this compensating winding is it is very expensive and it takes a lot of space in the machine. And therefore, normally compensating winding is not used in case of small machines. But compensating winding is normally used in case of large DC machines, and particularly if the machine is subjected to violent fluctuations in load. So in that case, compensating winding is preferred. Now the compensating winding which we have studied is capable of neutralizing the demagnetization effect, but it cannot neutralize the cross magnetizing effect. Now the problem of commutation, it is mainly because of two reasons. The first reason is cross magnetizing effect of armature reaction. We have seen that due to armature reaction, there is distortion of flux, and that's why magnetic neutral axis gets shifted, and which is the main reason of improper commutation. Then the second reason is reactance voltage. So we have also seen that whenever the coil is undergoing commutation, an EMF is induced in it due to the rate of change of current in it, and that voltage is called as reactance voltage. Now this reactance voltage causes sparking at the brushes whenever the coil is undergoing commutation, and therefore it is necessary to neutralize these two effects so as to obtain sparkless commutation or proper commutation. And for that we use two methods. The first method is called as resistance method. In resistance method, we use carbon brushes instead of low resistance copper brushes to reduce the sparking at brushes. And the second method, it is called as EMF method, in which we induce an EMF which is equal and opposite to the reactance voltage in the coil, and therefore sparkless commutation can be obtained. Now resistance method we will study in this video, and EMF method we will study in our next video. Let us now see the first method, that is resistance commutation. In this method, the low resistance copper brush is replaced by high resistance carbon brush. Now here three coils are shown, coil A, then coil B and coil C, and the coils are connected to commutator segments, and the brush is in contact with the commutator. Now here the coil undergoing commutation is coil B, because coil B is short circuited by commutator segments A, B and brush. Now during this short circuit period, the current coming from coil C, two paths are available. The first path, it is the shortest path. It is from coil C to commutator segment B and to brush. And the second path, it is the longer path, which is through short circuited coil B, then commutator segment A and the brush. So here current in this coil B, it is X, and therefore the current flowing from this shortest path, it will be I minus X. So current I minus X is coming out from this shortest path. Now if we are using copper brushes, then most of the current will flow through the first path, because the resistance of copper brush is very low, and therefore this current will be large and X will be negligible. Now the current coming out from this path, it is I plus X, because current in coil A is I and this current is X. So current from this path, it is I minus X, and the total current coming out of brush, it is 2I. Now if this I minus X is more, and when this brush leaves the commutator segment B, then this large current will be broken and heavy sparking will occur at the brush. On the other hand, if the magnitude of current X, if it is more, current in this path will be more and current in this path will be less, and therefore less current will be broken and we can reduce the sparking. And therefore sparking at brush can be reduced if more current flows through this longer path and less current flows through this shortest path. Now let us see what happens when the copper brush is replaced by a carbon brush with high resistance. Now instead of copper brush, if we use carbon brush, then most of the current will flow through the second path and less current will flow through the first path. This is because of two reasons. The first reason is the resistance of shortest path will go on increasing as the commutator moves. So when the commutator moves, the area which is in contact with the brush and commutator segment B, this area will go on reducing as the commutator moves. And due to reducing area of contact between brush and commutator segment B, resistance of this path goes on increasing, and therefore current through this shortest path will reduce. At the same time, the resistance of longer path, this path, this resistance will reduce, because the area of contact between the brush and commutator segment A goes on increasing as the commutator moves. So as the area of contact between commutator segment A and brush increases, resistance of this second path will reduce. And due to reduced resistance of second path, more current will flow through the longer path. And this results in reduced sparking at the brushes. And therefore, in case of DC machines, normally we use carbon brushes instead of copper brushes. Now let us see what are the advantages and disadvantages of carbon brushes. So first advantage, as we have already seen, the contact resistance of carbon brushes is high, and therefore it gives better commutation and sparking at the brushes will be reduced. Then second important advantage of carbon brushes is they provide self lubrication and they polish the commutator surface during rotation of commutator. So when the machine rotates, carbon brushes provide self lubrication and they polish the commutator surface. Then if sparking occurs and the brushes are made up of copper, then the damage caused will be more, whereas carbon brushes will cause lesser damage to the commutator whenever sparking occurs at brushes, and that's why carbon brushes are preferred to copper brushes. But there are some disadvantages also. The main disadvantage is due to high resistance of carbon brushes, there will be voltage drop at brushes. And this voltage drop is approximately of the order of 2 volt. Then another disadvantage is because of this high loss, we have to increase the size of commutator. Because this increased commutator size, it helps to dissipate the generated heat and it limits the temperature rise within permissible limits. Now the current density of carbon brushes is lower as compared to copper brushes, and therefore brush size will be large and the brush holders are also large. Now here you have to note one important thing, that just by using carbon brushes it is not possible to obtain sparkless commutation, because the main cause of sparking at brushes is the reactance voltage and distortion of flux due to armature reaction. And to overcome this, we have to use the second method, that is EMF method, which we will see in our next video. Thank you. Stay home, stay safe.